national unification. When the stadium ram beach at the grandstand, not the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.
Hello, good evening, and welcome into the Queen's Park Oval. And I can tell you, this could lose a roof or two here tonight. For the Knight Riders hosting the Guyana Amazon Warriors in match 18 of the Hero CPL in season 10, it doesn't get any more amped than this. It's a sellout, it's a full house, and when we look at the Hero leaderboard, it's the cellar dwellers. And who would have thought, if you said at the start of season 10, this would be happening, you'd be dreaming. But it is happening. These two powerful franchises go head to head and they're at the foot of the table. Yeah, a Hero CPL trophy in all its glory. And it is a cracking looking trophy indeed. And, a little while ago, Samuel Badra was at the coin toss and it went the way of the Warriors. And Shimran Hetmeister said, we'll have a bowl first, thank you, Kyron Pollard. And when you look at this lineup, it's very, very powerful. Akil Hussain is back. It's really the only change in the side. Prasanna goes out, so a little bit of likeness in terms of a spinner for a spinner. And a little bit of all-round quality there from Akil. But when you look at the side on paper, extraordinary. Poran, Webster, Munro, Seifert, Pollard, Russell, Nyrene, Rampal, Dupavillion and Seals, outstanding. And alongside Samuel Badri, the opposition.
Yeah, the Guyana Amazon Warriors. They made one change initially, Junior Sinclair in for Moti, but they've been forced to make another. Paul Stirling for Shea Hope just split his weapon just after the toss, and both captains agreed to the change, so Stirling is in, and so are four other overseas players. Of course, because the emerging player Junior Sinclair is there, it is permissible under the regulations. But another team that has misfired so far, and they'll expect all of their star players to get some runs, to get some wickets, and to get some valuable points here at the Queen's Park Oval. The ball seems to be missing. Where is it? Who's got it? Oh, the Moko Jambi has it from high to low. And there we go. Umpires are on their way. Really nice atmosphere, as always, at the Queen's Park Oval. Electrifying and captivating. Steel fans. Witco steel pans. The NGC Cooper Joylanders, I'm told they are representing the land of the steel pan, of course. And you're seeing some Guyana Amazon Warriors flags in the crowd. It's going to be a real high octane contest between these two teams. Traditionally, a very keen rivalry, and we expect no different here tonight.
Yeah, it's desperation stakes for sure. The coin toss going their way. We're going about the dew factor. I just wonder how heavy that dew will be, Sammy B, in terms of having to chase a target.
Yeah, it's already wet. There was some heavy rains earlier in that first game. So even before the start of the game, the outfield is quite wet, and it will only get wetter as we progress throughout the course of the night. So it's going to be very difficult bowling second. Wouldn't be straightforward bowling first either. As opening batsmen make their way out, Nicholas Puran once again had a half century opening last night for the Trinbago Knight Riders. The first time he's opened in this edition of the Hero CPL. And as always, the fans cheering their team on, their opening batsmen on, and they'll be expecting a win tonight. They've come here expecting a good performance. Disappointed last night, and the Trinbago Knight Riders can ill afford another disappointing performance here tonight. Both these teams, I hasten to add, are desperate for points.
Yeah, both heavyweights. Here's a heavyweight, Mario Shepherd, a strong individual. Let's see how he goes. He's been, well, he's blown a bit hot and cold, but he is a sensational athlete, to say the least. And, yeah, the vibe is extraordinary. Middle of the week, Wicked Wednesday and all. And the crowd, I'm feeling like goosebumps already. As Webster lines up with Nicholas Poran, So expect some excitement from Poran because he is in good form now with that half century as Samuel Badry just mentioned. But Tion Webster, he could do with a score here. The gifted one, the captain of the West Indies World Cup T20 side announced earlier. So he too could do with another score. Crowd will be massively expectant. Yeah, looking forward to this hugely because, as we've just shown you, the leaderboard. Who would have thought? These two powerhouse franchises at the bottom. Well, all in readiness. We've got Mrs. Reefa and Duguid out in the centre. And Nigel Duguid says, yeah, let's get on with proceedings. Except there's a change in the field. The Irishman, where have you been? Sturlo called it to the side because Shea Hove has split a webbing in warm-ups, we've been told. So he comes in to slip, there's Paul Sterling. And fielder from the onside comes to the offside. So they've got a very wide third man and a deep backward square. Rightio, ball one. Oh, it skids on! Given! Very first ball of the night! Do they want to check this out and review it? High fives all round for the Warriors. This kept low and skidded. Got to hurry up and make a decision here. Comes to Nicholas Poran. Oh! Ticking, ticking, ticking. Takes it. Just in the nick of time.
Well, I can tell you what, Danny. It wouldn't be on account of height. This one kept low. So if anything, it has to be missing the stumps. I think it was a good decision. Looking at it live, it looked out. But we'll await the decision from the review. In terms of ball tracking, it usually takes a little bit of time. But what a start if this is, in fact, a wicket for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Romario Shepherd, let's have a look first and foremost with the legality of the delivery. So that's good. Good length as well. It's just the line. Let's have a look. Yeah, nothing in terms of height, so it seems to be adjacent. I'm checking for any contact with the bat. Doesn't seem to be any contact with the bat.
Look at that height, Samuel B. And I just wonder, look, he's subtly off the ground. He's on his toes. Oh, I just wonder. Being given out on field. Waiting for ball tracking. Oh, and bingo, Tion Webster out for a golden one. Yep. Worst possible start for TKR has come to fruition. Confirmation from Nigel Duguid. And those from Guyana Amazon Warriors are loving this decision. Golden duck for Webster, and it's none for one. Strolls Colin Munro. The added tension and pressure of a top order player to come out so early. To the golden duck, well, some in the fraternity like to call it a diamond duck. Very first ball of an innings. Here's the next one. And it's bang on again. So asking you to play Romario Shepherd with his first two deliveries. What a fun 8 out magic moment, you better believe it. Opening batters will tell you they dread this when one is honing in. Straight away, your first sighter, and it skids on. Bingo.
Perfect start. An already dismal opening partnership of 10, average of 10. Well, that sinks even further now after that dismissal to 8.6. The average opening partnership for the Trinbago Knight Riders in 2022, 8.6 runs.
Oh, across the line again. Wow. Well, goes for leg byes. How much do you like this from Mario Shepherd? Henrik Claassen saying, I think it's going across with the angle. Chairman Hetmeyer's going, what do you reckon? Too late. Too late, brother. It's gone. Are they saying it's in time? Wow.
Just in the nick of time. Umpire has allowed the review. And this time, I think the height will be the question. Just by the look of it with the naked eye and the shot that he played and where it made contact. A little bit too high for my liking. But that's why we have that review, just to make absolutely sure. Doesn't seem to be too perturbed.
I reckon now he's giving that chewing gum a working over, isn't he, Munro? That's all fine. Oh, yeah, that chewing gum is getting one heck of a workout from Colin Munro, because, yeah, there's got to be a little bit of adrenaline pumping through the neck here for Munro. See how it lines up now. Pitched in, pitched on. Oh, I reckon. It's the back leg. Yeah, I think you're right, Samuel B. The height may be the factor. Yeah, the back knee's bent. Still got a good 4 feet to travel. He's come out. Oh, he's come out of the popping crease. I think, Samuel B., you're spot on. I think it's going to be too high.
Yeah, at best, it will remain umpire's call, even if it clips. Let's have a look. Yeah, just over, missing. And the ball did go for four leg byes as well. So bonus runs for the Trinbago Knight Riders. And a sigh of relief all around here at the Queen's Park Oval.
Yeah, four leg byes. Hemant here couldn't get to it. Scooted across down to third. So there are some runs on the board now for TKR. Oh, and a Frenchie to start as well. Oh, yeah. Romario Shepherd with a rueful grin.
Well, he didn't have the luck last night, did he? Colin Munro won a ricochet onto the stump from the pad on the body. Tonight, he's had the rub of the green so far anyway, inside edge, and could have gone easily onto the stumps. Instead, it goes comfortably wide and gets himself an inadvertent boundary. Really streaky, eventful first over. We're expecting a high-octane contest, folks. Keep locked on.
Oh, and a big half volley that Munro cannot drill and put away. Oh, there's a bit happening already. On the field and off the field. What a vibe. What a vibe in the Queen's Park Oval. Oh, love it here. Young captain. A lot of energy. A lot of vibe here for the Warriors. They need a win as well. They're so strong there, Munro, and he'll keep the strike. Little flick to backward square. First one done, it's 9 for 1. Talking all paints, as ever, for the ground staff. Mark out the creases. As the little, those white dots for the 4 foot line there. Once again, very brown, flat surface, devoid of live grass. At the moment, it's getting on with the new ball. This will be interesting. On debut, first match ever for Junior Sinclair. He is 21-year-old. He's coming for Gurugesh Mutti. Oh, nice start.
Yeah, good start. Not to be confused with Kevin Sinclair, another offie from Guyana.
And no cartwheeling Kevin here in the CPL at all. Oh, up. And I think it's gone all the way for Hero Maximum. Listen to the crowd.
Yeah, there's something about Monroe tonight. Usually when a batsman starts off scratchily, he gets runs. It's a batsman who starts off timing the ball and middling the ball. They don't usually score. Need confirmation whether or not this hit full on the advertising board might just have bounced inside. We need to magnify that to be absolutely sure. Is the signal? Leslie Reefer. And look at the eyes of Colin Monroe. Seems to be in a business-like mood tonight.
Crowd a little frustrated there. Thought it was going all the way. Hit the Toblerone boundary. I thought that cushion on the full, but no. Signal four. Ah, the Trinnies. And the dancing. The posse are in.
Nine deliveries bowled so far. We haven't seen Nicholas Puran yet. He's going to face his first delivery now. Yeah, good start by the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Wicked first delivery. Trinbago Knight Riders, not for the first time. They found themselves in this position. Need to do a rebuilding job.
Wow, it's not on purpose. I think he'd be a bit edgy and nervy here, Sammy. Tall fellow. That flight right, a little bit of bounce and pushing it through. Oh, Monroe has to hustle here. They're going to check this out for sure. Nigel Duguid says, listen, Butster, I need to hear from you. Dayton Butler upstairs.
Yeah, he isn't looking too confident, Colin Monroe. Just standing and staring. Only thing was the height of the throw. The wicketkeeper had to take it high and then come down low. So that would have taken some time. Let's have a closer look. Yeah. Needed to be a little bit lower. Of course, he was off balance throwing there, Sinclair. So I can't fault him too much. But it was a tight, tight single. And hear that roar from the crowd with that nut out. Can ill afford to lose another quick wicket here. Nicholas Puran was down the trap, so he had some momentum with him. Yeah, just the height of the throw. Only thing wrong with that. Excellent athleticism from the young man. Reminiscent of Cartwheel and Kevin.
Yeah, indeed. Well said, Sammy. Good hustle in the end from Munro. Again, watch those angles and watch those skiddy little arm balls with different angles. A lot of lefties, of course, for TKR. Hence, Sinclair getting a go. Lasco emerging player, this fellow definitely. Under 25 at the start of 2022. Nice little chip shot. Not quite get there. Kemo Paul does the rest. So eight from that second over at 17 for one. We'll be right back. BC, Kuva, Joylanders, Spencer by Metco, Steel Pans, this extraordinary sound here in the Caribbean. Vibe is, well, it's starting to amp to a new level, particularly if these two in the middle, Voran and Monroe, can get going and lighten things up by hitting the fence or going over inside the power play. Two overs done so far. The loss of Webster. More of Shepherd. Pace on. Hear the crowd, it'll tell you.
Yeah, the rhythm of the steel band has invigorated both Colin Monroe and Nicholas Puran. Teams of intent and aggression from both of them. Aligned from Romario Shepherd and just helped on its way. A little bit of a swivel from Nicky P. And despite the loss of that early wicket first ball, they've been quite positive and purposeful. Lots of vibes, lots of energy.
Flowing is Puran, and say at half century last night, and pace on from Shepherd. He'll be mindful of that too. I wonder, he's going to just maybe pull out a couple of slower balls in this over. And he had two, and that pace on and disappear very, very quickly, as we all know. Deep backward square. The man, it's almost like a deep backward point, not at third. So here's it, a short third man. And it went over to his head. Flashing and racing for four more. Hustling now, Pora.
Yeah, not exactly the area that he would have wanted it, Colin Monroe. Nicholas Puran, rather. A thick outside edge. But pace on and width always going to be a dangerous delivery. A risky delivery. Good man in the circle as well. Yeah, four fours. Only into the third over. I just wonder if Romario Shepherd will change the angle and perhaps go round the wicket to cramp him for room. He stays over.
It's a wonderful slower ball. If you've got a great slower ball, he's going to pace on again. Get back, Colin. Don't get in the way of Romario there. Or Sterling, yeah. Big front row coming at you.
And this is the sort of delivery that you'll be aiming for on a consistent basis. The deliveries that are attacking the stumps. If the batsman has to score, let him take a risk, particularly in the power play. Don't give them that width or that length to free their arms. And that's why experience is so important.
Goodbye and good night. Now this is a hero maximum. Nicholas Puran.
Yeah, absolutely smoked it, given the length. Just talking about that, can't be that short. Able to pick up that quite easily, Nicholas Puran. Packs some power way over and into the stands. That's a magnificent blow.
Should be worth eight. Oh, yeah, the length. Line is round about off stump, just fractionally outside. So, wonderful fetch. And they're discussing this now. Odin Smith having a chat with his good buddy, Romario Shepherd. Again, I'll say it. Those bowlers that possess a variety of slower balls, back of the hand, little cutters. Oh, there you go. It doesn't matter. Pace on. Shepherd lets him know. El Dorado celebration from the big guy. And Poran's got to go.
Yeah, lots of passion from Romario Shepherd has been pumped in this over. 14 runs in five deliveries previously. Nicholas Puran might feel a little bit unlucky, but a good catch from the wicketkeeper. Republic Bank Classic. And that's exactly what they needed. The Amazon Warriors, Warrior Nation, wherever you are, will be jumping up and celebrating. Nicholas Puran goes, just 15, 31 for two.
Timmy Seifert in early again. So he's in at four, and he's inside the power play too. And like a lot of the top order could do with the score. Well, he's just said, you guys upstairs, you can get stuffed with your slower balls. I'm going with this. Pace on. Man, what a good catch from Hendrik Claassen. That was humming. Claassen is a big man for a keeper. And those big mitts did well. So are the Caribs. Go Teddies. And go the Warriors. Yeah, just enough. Good enough. It skims away here from Munro.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. The loss of two wickets or not. Colin Munro is still going to play his shots. Just enough to get over the head of the fielder in mid-off, gets himself a boundary first ball of the over. Not really a bad delivery from the young man, Junior Sinclair from Rose Hall Town in Bribies, the last of seven siblings. I'm sure all of his family and his friends looking on debut. Danny Morrison, he'll want to acquit himself well. Always good to see the young players getting opportunities and rubbing shoulders with the experienced ones. Lots of experienced spinners in the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Wickets falling in the power play. Such a crucial phase. You want to start well with bat, with ball. Trinbago Knight Riders, 14 wickets. And they're in their fifth game. Barbados Royals, who've won all, have only lost four. So important, the start. And so far, so good for Junior Sinclair. Tall off spinner, has a nice relaxed approach to the crease. You'd expect that he will get some bounce when he does pitch it. In that area, wouldn't look for too much turn in the power play. So he'd be, I would think, focusing wicket to wicket. Seifert was dismissed by Mujib, remember? Last night, played on.
Too dissimilar to that sort of line that turned back from Majeed. Not so much here from Sinclair. So a little sigh of relief from Seifert as well. He gets off the mark here tonight. Of course, the long on back. Whichever batter's on strike, doesn't matter left or right, but it was a lovely stroke for Munro to start this over, back over. Long off, who's up inside the circle. Just in trouble gripping the ball.
Yeah, it's wet. We started off wet. As I mentioned before, there was some rain earlier today, so it's quite wet to start the game. So it wouldn't be too straightforward for the spinners. A couple of wrist spinners to come later on. Shamsi and Tahir. Four of us gone, 38 for two.
CPL 60 chat app, so fans can have a wee chat with us commentators, throw in a few emojis, get passionate, have a chat. The CPL 60 chat app. With all this vibe happening, is the place to be if you love your cell phones, which we all do. Time for a bit of chemo Paul, it looks like. Yep, going to replace Romario Shepherd, and he will come round to the left-hand of Munro. Going about to pace on, and Shepherd, quite a different character to Chemo Paul, who now will probably employ a few of those little subtle changes of pace rather than big Romario. See how he goes in terms of holding the ball. All the players pretty much have got rags, they've got little towels with them. Keep ticking along and looking after the ball, the presentation of the seam, and the, trying to keep it as dry as possible. Over now, Kima.
And oftentimes we've seen Imran Tahir bowl an over or two in the power play. And see him going through some warm-ups right now, so he might just bowl the final over of the power play. Look at that, that's not a rag. That's a towel. That's a bath towel.
That's a beach. He's off to the beach. He's still low. Get in there, Chief. Bit late. The sun's gone down. But, oh, we love it here in the night. Hang on with a night swing. Well, he waited with the slowness of that. It's well played by Cypher, but brilliantly fielded too in the covers. Sinclair as well. Good hunting, young man.
And this is what you want to see. As a bowler, as a captain, you want to see that sort of commitment. It really lifts your spirit. It lifts the spirit of everyone. You can see that slow ball from Chemo Paul. You've been harping on that, Danny Morrison. So far, this young man has looked good.
Well, I just simply think in this fabulous format, you got to own about three, four, or five of them. Different cutters. Such a good surface whilst it's new and sliding on. That's an on-paced one there. Appreciably quicker here from Chemo Paul. Tucking up Cypher.
Yeah, it's been a challenge for the Trinbago Knight Riders throughout this Hero CPL. They haven't really adjusted to surfaces that they've played on. Again, making the transition from St. Lucia to here, the Queen's Park Oval. Haven't revved up as yet. Eighth year of sponsorship from Hero. Synonymous with the CPL. Own themselves in a difficult situation, the Knight Riders. They've been forced almost to play Aki Lucien tonight. They didn't play him last night. 24 hours later, he's playing. Because they lost, and they're getting to that stage where they need to win virtually every game. Had they won last night, you might have thought he would have rested. Your next game is in a couple of days' time, but because the results haven't gone their way, they've been almost cursed to play him. Valuable addition, but you don't want him to get injured.
And I've just noticed here too, Sammy, Imran Tahir doing his little exercise routine. Going to come over or around? I think he's going to come around here. Yeah, Chemo Paul. Round to Munro. And finishes off the fifth. Just two from it, a good one from Chemo Paul. And the Knight Riders are 40 for two here.
Five overs gone, so run rate's okay. Exactly eight, but they have lost two wickets. John Webster early, and then the loss of Nicholas. as Puran as well. Imran Tahir with his first over of the evening. A very good evening, Darren Ganga.
Evening, Simon. Hello, everyone. Keen battle unfolding. Third over of spin in the power play, significant. Similar ploy used by teams here at the Queen's Park Oval in previous matches.
Think back to last night and Tim Seifert's dismissal. Was it Mujib? Just got one to nip back through the gate. It hit the inside edge and then back onto the stumps. Better.
This is what you've been talking about, Salman Dool. A conventional off-spin coming into the right-hander. Tim Seifert just getting an inside edge onto the stumps.
Right, so he has managed to keep Colin Munro quiet through the CPL. It strikes at just 96.2, 51 of 53, with a couple of dismissals, nearly three, right there.
Yeah, and it's smart by Shimran Hetmar to use a bowler as reputable as Imran Tahir against Colin Munro. The bowl, quite a few wrong ons going across the left-hander. But he's trying to close the power play phase out without conceding too many runs. Hetmeyer.
Driven hard, but there is an inside the circle in the form of Odin Smith, I think that is. It's across quickly. Another one named in the West Indies squad. T20 World Cup down under in Australia. Odin Smith, his name read out this afternoon with Desmond Haynes and Ian Bishop. All the explanations required. Was good to watch that excellent interview, and I thought Desmond Haynes was outstanding in his forthright answers and his honesty. Six gone, 43 for two. Colin Munro, hero CPL classic moments that we're bringing to you throughout this 2022 version of hero CPL. 96 not out of 50 deliveries against the Jamaica Tullawas. This was at the magnificent Sabina Park in Jamaica. Also part of the TKR's highest total in hero CPL history of 267 for two. What a night out that was for Colin Munro. Of course, 10 years of celebrating hero CPL. This version has been just as good, just as exciting. Cannot wait to get down to Guyana as well for the last 14-15 days. Wouldn't the Amazon Warriors love to pick up a win tonight before they head down to their home patch, Darren Ganga? What a party that'll be.
Yeah, I can't wait. I understand that things are kicking off this weekend. Saturday, September 17, the Guyana Festival, the mega concert. It's a musical fiesta, so to speak, that will kick off the week of Cricket Carnival. We, of course, will be floating in next week, hoping to join into the activities. Hope all Guyanese and all visitors participate. That's the one mega Guyana concert at the Providence Stadium at 7 p.m. on the 17th. Go get your tickets. Be part of the launch of the Cricket Carnival first time ever.
Yeah, and all organised as well and hugely supported by the government of Guyana. Doing a terrific job down there. They're prospering at the moment, Guyana, and doing some great things. Cannot wait to get down there. This is good. This has been a good start to our week here in Trinidad and Tobago as well. Magnificent Caribbean countries, and what a great place to be celebrating 10 years of Hero CPL. Hard for his protection as well.
...19 balls since the last boundary, so it's a good little phase here for the Warriors. Shimron Hetmyer has brought some calm to this franchise. Looks quite assured as a captain. Very much aware of his players' strengths.
And he will make little errors, or there will be things that we pick up on, I'm sure, along the way, but all you want is to learn from those little mistakes. And he spoke quite honestly about the Romario Shepherd over. He said he'd actually do the same thing. He backs him, and he went to him, and yeah, he didn't quite get it right in that particular game, but it's you're not going to get everything right, are you, Darren? You captained enough, you know that you're not going to get everything right, although the latter in life we go and the more we see each other, the more right we were.
Yeah, it reminds me of Rohit Sharma and how he invested in Avish Khan to bowl the last over against the West Indies. I think it was the third T20 international India loss. And that's the way you help in the growth of players within your team. So it's not just about the instant reward, it's about the investment for the future. So who knows? Romario Shepherd might be the star in the playoffs. He's already started with the ball today, so he's learned from that experience. He's a better player from it. So all credit to Shimron Hetmyer for trusting his young charges.
Well done, Emmy. In the end, it will be one, but could he easily have slipped underneath those hands and away to the boundary for four. Seven overs gone, 47 for two. Plenty of candidates in the house tonight for the Hero Fan of the Match. Oh my, that, just get the check out. Look at that. Please. Wow. What a get up that is. Yes. Stand up, sir. Enjoy. Like a selfie thing going on there.
Yeah. I did participate in one of those earlier. But he's already prepared for Carnival 2023 here in Trinidad and Tobago.
Yeah, I think it's a ring light, isn't it? It's a ring light for a selfie. I think maybe just taken around the crowd, and yeah, there you go. Some noise, the faithful of the TKR. I went pinch one now, just snuck past Imran Tahir. Seen this a little bit, Darren, haven't we, already in the first couple of games, where the power play, the first three, four, five overs of the power play have been relatively good, 40 after five. And then just things are just tailed off, struggled through the middle period.
Get on you, mate.
I guess, Simon, past performances very much at the forefront of these batters' mind. And as much as you try to block it off, you still have that weighing on your efforts brings up the 50 with this fine stroke. We will have to check that effort to ensure that the boundary was saved. Colin Ingram running around, doing quite well.
Yeah, it's tough on this. I feel that maybe, just maybe, the hip was on the rope or the advertising at the same time, was it? A hand, oh, just might have got off. Dear. I'm going to give it 3 for effort.
I'm going to give it a save. That's brilliant. Just getting the angle right. He doesn't get the majority of his body into the advertising board. The hand, that left hand, just tapping the ball back at the right time before the momentum of the slide goes into the boundary line.
Yeah, I don't think the hand is on the advertising triangle there, is it? Moved as yet. It's the hand and the ball comes out of the hand. I think everything's okay, actually. That's a really good effort, Colin Ingram. And in the end, they've only taken 2 as well. So that's pretty average running as well, I think.
Yeah, just for a couple, it should be 3 at least.
Pinch one off the last. So 5 runs off the Imrantai here over. 8 overs bowled, 52 for 2. So plenty of power to come, but it's power that has not fired as yet in Pollard and Russell in the tournament. Gentleman Ryan, I thought, was good last night. He aided in that partnership with Nicholas Poor, and they couldn't quite finish the innings off in the end, but it was a vital little innings that Narayan played coming in at number 7 last night. Odine Smith for the first time this evening. Come around the wicket to the left-handed Munro. Yeah, deep backward point, deep square leg, deep mid-wicket. Long on and a long leg in place.
Look, when you reflect on what has transpired in this TKR unit, from a batting perspective, of course, they've fallen short of expectations and their own expectations. So there's a little bit of fear in their approach. Sometimes that fear pushes you to be conservative. The contrasting thing is this format of the game requires you to be fearless. So as a player, you've got to jump over and beyond that obstacle to start with. That's a real challenge in my estimation for this batting lineup. How they transition from having fear and worrying about their wickets to having the courage to attack the opposition and play with their natural instinct.
Yeah, and it's hard because everybody looks at you and they see the named players. They see the big names, the Pollards, the Russells, the Purans, the Munros, Narayan, and they see it's power-packed. And so the opposition are prepared and they will in turn probably come harder. And when you're down, they want to keep you down because they know that if you get on a run, you're going to be very, very dangerous in the tournament.
Reminds me of a famous Michael Jordan quote. Never say never, because limits, like fears, are just illusions. You've got to find a way to push that aside. Focus on what is in front of you and just believe in your ability, that process to get results.
All hard and straight. Excellent work. No. Oh, Mr. Sinclair, that's not your best.
It's on debut. Had to bowl a couple difficult overs. When he reflects on this, he won't be very happy with this effort. Junior Sinclair looked quite athletic previously. That's quite elementary, a stop to make at this level.
Get a roar from the crowd if he picks this one up cleanly.
Look, I watched him closely in his first couple overs and he reminds me a bit of Roger Harper, the right-arm off-spinner from Guyana. That non-bowling arm, how it opens out, palm facing upwards. We'll have to wait and see how he grows in this game.
It's a way over backward point. Oh, dear me, Imran. There's a couple of poor pieces of fielding in this over already. Odin Smith not happy, and rightly so. Two deliveries that should have been singles have both gone for four, and all of a sudden, with the ball to go, the over's gone for 11.
Catching and ground feeling as important as batting and bowling. Standards just dropping a bit. Consecutive blunders, which allows for a couple more runs for the Knight Riders.
Yeah, he's still has high standards, Imran Tahir. He knows that even playing the game at the age of 42, 43, he still sets himself high standards. And he'd be disappointed with that.
Twice the age of Junior Sinclair, who's 21.
Yeah, he's more submerging than emerging, isn't he? I would say. Have to bowl that one again. Well, Odin Smith. Well, all our wonderful night shots brought to you by the Omega XL Skycam. It's on its way up now. Got up there very quickly, but it brings us some wonderful shots. Push for two this time, will they? No. Satisfied with 13 from the over, a good one for TKR, 65 for two. Oh, that's stunning. Great shots from high above this wonderful cricket ground here in Port of Spain. Where the Trinbago Knight Riders are at with their squad. I mean, you look at their starting a lineup and you think it's about as good as they can pick. But the problem is the players they have picked just have not performed as yet. So I don't see them making change. The only change I might see at the moment is Teon Webster. He's had one good game and then four failures. So whether they go to Munro, I wanted to see Munro at the top. He was in their second ball tonight, so that's fine. I'd love to see him back opening the batting. But this is it's a tough ask up against this Warriors outfit, Shamsi now. And he's got four overs available to him. So he's still got a couple remaining. Sinclair's got a couple left if he wants. So there's plenty of overs of spin still in the tank.
Nice little period for the Knight Riders, a partnership of 35 from 38.
should get themselves in a good position to launch at the end. Problem is, the likes of Karen Pollard, Andre Russell, they haven't fired. So even if you get to that position, I feel it's important for one of these two to go deep, very deep. If they can bat all the way, it will assist this Knight Riders batting first and getting a solid total.
Long way outside off stump there, Colin Munro. Very square on. We've seen that he's got that crouched stance. And he's just waiting there, I think, for the wrong end. He'll look to pounce on it leg side, but he's a long way outside the line of off stump. Yeah, I look at it now and I think anywhere around about 100 with five to go. If one of those players, if someone can come off, Pollard, Russell, Narine, then 155, 160 is on the cards. And that is, I think, on this surface, very, very competitive.
Well, when you look at what transpired against Barbados Royals, they were 98 for 4 after 15 with Andre Russell still in the shed. And still, they only managed 132. So that's why I feel they need to capitalize on this start from either of Munro or Seifert. You have to play according to the form of your team as well.
The other thing is, Darren, you look at their last three 10-over scores, so they're in a way better spot right now already. Last three games, 10-over scores, 53 for 4, 45 for 3, 51 for 7 after 8 overs due to rain. So they're in a great position now. I mean, this is perfect position, 69 for 2.
All things trending in their direction, the Knight Riders. Could this shift their form in the tournament? And you know, Simon, the modern game requires you to utilize all your batting capacity. Sometimes you've got to recognize, as I mentioned earlier, the form that your team is in. It's a little bit traditional for you to ask one of your top three to bat through the innings, but I feel you've got to creep before you walk. Get to a total, get a win, and then push your efforts further. Try to get to the pulse of the modern game as the tournament progresses, from a batting perspective, of course.
Very comfortable half a dozen off the 10th over. 71 for 2 at the halfway stage, and it will be an Angostura chill break.
71 for 2 at the halfway mark of the Trinbago Knight Riders innings. Munro 35 from 32. Tim Seifert less than a runner ball, 16 from 20. Still to come, Pollard, Russell, Akil Hussain, Narine. Romario Shepherd was good up front, picking up the wickets of Webster and then Nicholas Puran. Still overs to come from Shamsi and Imran Tahir, importantly. Samuel Badri alongside me, the two wickets that fell.
First ball off the contest, Romario Shepherd on target. And then the last ball of his second over. Went for a few in that over, and you can see the passion in getting that wicket off Nicholas Puran.
Nice view overlooking Port of Spain, and then we move further up to the northeast of Trinidad and Tobago, the lighthouse in Toco. Been there quite a lot. It is a focal point and a nice landmark when you visit the northeastern side of the country. Several prominent cricketers have emanated from those parts, and it has stood the test of time. If you come to Trinidad, you should pay a visit to couple of hours outside of Port of Spain, the capital city. Very natural surroundings and lovely fishing villages. But for now, it's bat and ball action. Knight Riders will be hoping to put on how many you think at the back end here, Samuel Badri.
Yeah, I think they'll be looking upwards of 160, so maybe further 90 runs, 89 runs. Not going to be easy. It hasn't been a particularly easy pitch to come and blast and to score boundaries quickly and easily. It's going to be a challenge, but they need to get, I suspect, over 150. They can get that with Akil Hussain back in the lineup. Sunil Narayan, that's 8 overs that they can control. And they'll be hoping that the fast bowlers, the other bowlers, can support them. But a job to do with the bat firstly. Munro started off quite rapidly. Lots of boundaries early in his innings, got off to a flyer. But post the power play, he slowed down considerably. And these two will be best placed to assess the conditions, assess the pitch, and determine what would be a competitive score. Wet outfield, factor that in with your spinners as well.
See most of the players with those rags. It was very damp from the early rainfall before play started, and that won't get significantly better. If anything, it'll get significantly worse. Sit down.
From Colin Munro, not the connection that he would have liked. The other thing that'll be going through their minds, the batting to come, like you mentioned, the Pollard, the Russell, the real power hitters. How many overs can they just continue like that? 11 gone, 77 for 2.
three ball strikers. And then you add Akil Hussain in there, back in the contest. There's Akil talking to Dinanath Ramnarayan, former West Indies leg spinner, who's in the shorts. Debray Shamsi. Shimron Hetmeyer has been very, very animated, directing traffic out in the middle.
One to two, not on. Tabri Shamsi, former number one ranked T20 international bowler in the world. Lots of experience in these parts. Came with South Africa in 2021. Did wonders in that T20 international series. Played previously with the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. Number two in the T20 international rankings currently. Josh Hazlewood number one. Not often we've seen a fast bowler at the top.
He's found the gap. It's a shot that Munro used to play so often in his early journey with TKR. Put it away for a while and has brought it back out again.
Yeah, I've felt the brunt of this shot on a number of occasions. Plays it really well. Brings up the 50 partnership, 51 of 51. And it really is off-putting for a bowler when a batsman plays these types of shots. You can see that from Shamsi's reaction. Two fielders behind point, despite that, still tries to take them on. He's batting comfortably outside the off stump as well.
Down to Sterling. And he takes it. That is a wonderful catch. A Republic Bank classic. The shoe is off. The phone call made. Imran Tahir still got his on. So he's not received the call. It's a shaking of hands for him.
It's a wonderful catch. Make no mistake about it. It was dipping and dying on Paul Sterling. Let's have a look about the legality. Yes, that's fine. Munro was outside off stump. Shamsi chose to bowl leg stump. Played the shot, and look at that. Dipping, dying, dropping. A good catch, inches off the ground from Paul Sterling. Just hanging around to make sure that he's dismissed, and he is. Munro goes for 42, 82 for three.
Shimron Hetmeyer has gone solidly, has had my eye on him from ball number one. There he goes again, very animated, but very precise in his field placings all the way from the first over. And now a big moment. TKR have been building towards the Russell Pollard heavy lifting at the back end. Just 34 runs so far this season. They are to get anything competitive in the back end here. These guys have to do some heavy lifting. I'm not saying it's going to happen. Off the mark straight away.
Shamsi picking up the wicket of Munro. Like I mentioned, he was outside the off stump. You can't see from that angle. But Shamsi trusted the line. Bowled that ball on the leg stump, on the stumps, on the wicket. Maybe Munro wanted him to do that, but he didn't get the connection that he would have liked. And a good catch, really good catch from Paul Sterling. Trinbago Knight Riders have to find a way to get Andre Russell into this tournament. With bat, with ball. Hasn't fired yet. It's come ahead of the captain, Karen Pollard, tonight. Lots of overs remaining. We have a trial by spin, that's for sure. Shamsi, as well as Imran Tahir. Might also be tempted, Bish, to think about saving an over or two for Kyron Pollard. Of spin, that is.
Russell very wide. The playing surface. 83 for 3. Chill, refreshing moment, soaking in the action. It's hit on the knife edge. He's got his helmet and showing you his colors. Good to see the young ones out here. TKR fan to the mix. Imran Tahir for his final over. Good workout in the deep. Colin Ingram.
Yeah, look out for the googly. From Imran Tahir. He likes to bowl that against the right-handers. I want to make sure that this was well fielded. Yeah, it seems to be okay. Imran Tahir is such a guileful bowler.
Hasn't hit it well enough, hasn't hit it well enough, and taken. Romario Shepherd takes a simple catch and Imran Tahir is off. El Dorado celebration.
Yep, he's not gotten into this tournament, Andre Russell. Gone again cheaply. Not entirely sure if it was a googly. Doesn't matter for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Wicket, the big wicket of Andre Russell, trying to take on the spin in the air, in the air, in the air, and in the hand. And that was the moment he was off. Like a sprinter, Imran Tahir, look at that. Russell goes cheaply yet again for 3, 85 for 4.
Sunil Narine replaces Andre Russell.
Looking for the hero maximum. A good catch, a good running catch from Romario Shepherd. Nice and slow from Tahir, tempting Andre Russell. And his travails continue. Imran Tahir, the evergreen. Imran Tahir, the first time he has dismissed Andre Russell in CPL, mind you. Saifut, 21 from 27. No Kyron Pollard just yet. Warrior Nation at this stage would be ahead, you'd think. This man still in the hut.
Come out.
he too has struggled in the 2022 edition.
Slip in place for Sunil Narine. Could see the googly. Good moving there from deep extra cover by Kimo Paul.
Just a couple deliveries left for Imran Tahir in this spell. Just want to see him off, see these last two balls off, no more damage done.
Good, the Warriors, very energetic, very vibrant. They look hungry. They started the tournament slowly, and they haven't gotten home yet, but they're very, very energized. I mean, a couple of bloopers in the field, but that's okay. End of a spell for Imran Tahir. 1 for 19 from four. Good night out for Imran Tahir. Very economical and picking up that significantly important wicket of Andre Russell in that final over. Now a little bit of off spin. Sinclair from the Rose Hall Youth Club. Another one of those players who emanate from Burbese, like Romario Shepherd, like Shimron Hetmeyer, like Guda Keshmoti. Good save again, getting down.
He's bowled a couple overs in the power play. An opportunity now with some protection, boundary riders. It'll be interesting to see if he tries to spin it, tries to bowl it a little bit slowly against the left-handed Narine, or if he will just try to fire it in. Three spinners in operation for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Variety as well. Right-hand wrist, left-hand wrist, right-hand off-spin. Always good as a captain when you have that variety and you can have those matchups lined up. Wonder what is going through the mind of Seifert presently. 23 from 29. This
is an indication of how much moisture there is out there. Ball is going to be discussed, and maybe they'll think the seam is very trodden and soaked, and they may want to change. Yeah, I think they're going to change it. Partly due to that sprinkle we had just maybe an hour or so before the game started, and now the implications of additional dew formation. It'll be good for young Sinclair in the middle of an over to get a dry ball. It'll help him at least for a few deliveries. Of course, one of the sponsors, Creamery Novelties, proudly owned and manufactured right here in Trinidad and Tobago, offering delicious treats for ice cream lovers, of which we have many in our commentary position and throughout the country. A wide variety of flavors like Neapolitan, soursop and peanut. You can also delight in the lollies, choco bars and cornettos. Let's see as the action starts again with a removal of that damp ball. That's the one that's been removed from play. There's a dry one now, whether it grips initially. Oh, just running on.
Wouldn't mind that too much, Sinclair, from hand to bat, back to hand. So it remains dry, at least for another delivery.
Straight, very straight. Sinclair puts his head down. Narine looks up. And that's come down our way for a hero maximum.
Yeah, he knew immediately. He missed his length. Narine just gave himself a little bit of room towards the leg side to free his arms. And boy, did he free his arms. A wonderful strike. Straight over the bowler's head towards the side screen. He knew immediately. Didn't even bother to look back. Don't miss your length.
Sides it over. Point. Should get a couple. They do. 14 overs now completed. 99 for four.
It's a rivalry of long time. It's not about it's about the curry chicken and the chicken curry, but it's about the cricket. So the rivalry is about when Trinidad and Guyana Amazon playing is about a close finish, not an easy walkover. So that is the whole rivalry anytime in all formats of the game. So all the way, Guyana Amazon Warrior!
All right, what do you want to say back to him now that he's told you what he thinks?
It's a close finish, but we'll definitely win tonight. Once we put up a score over 160, we're good to go. And we're definitely giving them curry chicken tonight. And no curry, no chicken curry, only curry chicken.
Yeah. Well, you're clearly really outnumbered here. How are you going to take on all of these people?
Well, we will take on them one by one. And ending of the game, we will see the Amazon Warrior flag rising high in the air, all the way.
All right, okay, I guess you're gonna give your one last answer to him and show him how you're gonna celebrate when your team wins.
Exactly, because it's TKR forever and Amazon Warriors never.
All right, I guess you know how this energy's gonna go, and good luck to both the teams right now.
Oh, I love that. TKR forever, Amazon Warriors never. She's rightly on television. Odine Smith.
Yeah, just when they've gotten some momentum, the Trinbago Knight Riders, they've lost a wicket. When a partnership is beginning to build, the Amazon Warriors have come back strongly, come back well, has been the trend so far in this game. Knight Riders will be looking to finish off strongly, and as the young lady mentioned, the score of 160 will be quite challenging. Takes some getting from the Trinbago Knight Riders, but with these two and Pollard and Akil Hussein, not impossible. Amazon Warriors, on the other hand, have done a wonderful job to date, and they too would be wanting to finish off the inning strongly with the ball.
Tim Seifert, 27 from 33, versus one boundary. Maybe needs a sugar rush from the creamery. He'll need to start lifting his tempo beyond this over. Deep mid-wicket, deep square, long on. Just six off the over. 15 overs completed, 105. For four. Steady power play, the middle overs, the blue towers have been moderate. The blue devils have been very prominent, part of carnival celebrations, if that's your thing. Maybe some exorcism needed here at the Queen's Park Oval if TKR to try to get to winning ways. The Amazon Warriors, quite prominent. Well, we've had the Blue Devils, and it's an appropriate time to say hello to Danny Morrison.
And red. Snap, Bish. Shepherd is back. And he does start with a slow one. He was roaring in with the two overs with the new C. He got 2 for 19. It was pace on. Of course, now we're heading into the death overs. A little bag of tricks is required. Nice little start. Soon will arrive. Ah. Temptation. We're revving up here. Where's he going to go now, Narayan? Can't quite get going, can he? And neither can Seifert. Seifert's holding things together, though. He's 27 from 33. Might not be striking all that high, but they really have needed someone to just hold here, be the glue, as it were, for the Knight Riders when other wickets have fallen by the wayside. Darren Ganga, one of the favourite sons of Trinidad and Tobago, is alongside.
Hi everyone. So intense this battle, 106 for 4. No one team jumping far ahead. Credit to the Warriors, they're bowling quite disciplined. They've used spin to good effect. 50% of the overs were spin overs in the power play, and then 6 of 9 through the middle phase, all spinners. Imran Tahir, exceptional with his economy and that important wicket to go with it. Chipped in the air, Hetmeyer, the fielder, gets in, completes the catch. Fine example from the captain, leading from the front. And it's another wicket for the Warriors. a shift once again in this game.
Well, don't underestimate how good this take is. Going about the night sky, ball falling. Seifert, yeah, he gets a low one. He slices it somewhat. Does not get it out of the screws. Oh, brilliant. Absolutely. Republic Bank Classic, most definitely. And Seifert's vigil has come to an end. 27 from 35, and the Knight Riders lose their fifth at 106.
Captain Pollard. 3 wickets for Mario Shepherd. He's making a statement, not included in the West Indies T20 World Cup side.
Yeah, seen some bolters, haven't we? This is magnificent. He steadied himself, he did a sidestep and thought, I can get there, said Shimron Hetmeyer. Yeah, cover good ground, because I think he didn't quite pick it up in terms of the distance. That's always the challenge in the night sky with the white ball.
Danny Morrison, might I add, I'm so disappointed that he wasn't included in that squad for the West Indies in that World Cup.
Amazing when you think it's in Australia. Mang bowls a good heat, hits a strong ball.
Single. Soft and quiet end to the over. A successful one for Mario Shepherd. 108 for 5. Right, 4 overs remaining. Which team will win these 4 overs? That's going to be crucial. Stage is set for Karan Pollard, Sunil Narine. Knight Riders, they were in a similar sort of situation in the game against Barbados Royals. Failed to capitalize in the last 5. 34 and lost 6 wickets. They need to change that. Well, that has a very good strike rate against Kimo Paul, 187. What he's done previously, 92 runs from 48 balls.
Well, this is it. This is the massive part of this innings. Kyron Pollard coming in a little later at 7 instead of 6 in the death overs. Can he get set? Settle in, yeah, briefly, just a couple, and then get going. And I think that's the other thing about it, Darren Gang, is that you lose the star quality of Andre Russell, now not batting, gets out in the start of the 13th over. Sacrilege in a way. With the stroke he played, and now he got sucked into the trap. He's too good a player for that, with so much experience and so much key quality to be supposed to be batting now for TKR.
Narine, 14 from 12. Yeah, just to finish my point on Romario Shepherd, who was left out of the West Indies World Cup team in 2021 when I felt he should at least been part of the reserves, knowing fully well that there's a following World Cup in 2022. He's quite expensive, but that's not the only value that he brings to a T20 team. He's a good fielder. He can strike a long ball. He's a match winner with the bat. I just feel he has to be managed better as a bowler. Use him in the middle phase. Today he made an impact, a significant impact. First ball, the wicket of Tion Webster. Then last ball off the power play, Nicholas Puran. Then Colin Monroe. I feel Sheldon Cottrell is quite lucky to be in this squad at the expense of maybe Romario Shepherd.
You mentioned there, manage him well. I think clearly you don't use him at the death. You need to be a specialist death bowler, and he's clearly not. Maybe not at this stage of his career, but maybe later on, who knows. But exactly that, Darren Gangi. You use him sparingly. And again, as we know in T20, you only bowl six balls sometimes, then you're off, and then someone else is on and whatever. But yeah, I agree. At the top, and then a bit of those middle stages, he's a wicket taker. Oh, I like that from Chemo Paul. I really like that. It's that tennis ball one that maybe a bit of latitude with a height, but still, it's the thought process that's good from Chemo Paul.
Well, Karen Pollard has a chance here to earn his wage. It's about that time that he contributes with the bat as captain of this Trinbago Knight Riders team into their fifth game, and Pollard hasn't done anything significant with the bat.
Oh, what a contest. This is great. A tennis ball bouncer that never really arrives and loops past, and then another one. Really brave, truly smart from Chemo Paul. And then there's a little bit of byplay with a few words from big Kyron Pollard. Look at that. Thought it was in the slot, but it never really arrived. And he had to reach a little bit for KP, and he couldn't.
Nice delivery. I know, Danny, he's one of your favorites, Kyron Pollard.
Where to now? Now he's going to keep the strike. Only half a dozen from the 17th. It's 114 for five here.
Projected scores at 10 runs per over from here on in. They get to 144. The Braves, Shamsi with the ball. And if you want to watch Hero CPL for free in the Caribbean, download the Sports Max app. Great opportunity for all West Indian and Caribbean fans. There is Pollard, Hero Maximum to start the over. That's a statement from the big man.
Yeah, things start revving up now in the death overs. Can Pollard pull out a bit of magic here? Because he's got a maximum at the start of a new over against Shamsi. Yeah, no mean feat, just fractionally short, just a little too short. Yeah, he knows it.
Buckle up, folks. What's Shamsi going to do? Look out for that wrong on that goes across Karen Pollard.
Yeah, I like that. That's gutsy because it's a little slower. At times, does he bowl a slower one or does he scoot it through? You've got to be so careful against Pollard with the extra reach, the height of Pollard. Yeah, he just slowed it down. Beautifully bowled.
Up and away. Flies over the head of Shimron Hetmeyer in that long on position. Euro maximum number two in the over.
Decibels have just got a little bit more here. He's got a hell of a strike rate against Shamsi, and he knows it. Does Trevay Shamsi. That says it all. A bit of Venus flytrap expressions. Oh!
8 sixes and 36 balls. This Pollard Shamsi matchup. Pollard dominant against Shamsi and showing that once more.
Oh, it's fascinating. You're about matchups. Kimo Paul's on at the other end. Ray Shamsi's on this end. Both have not got out Kyron Pollard. They'll be aware of it, but they're certainly up for it. A great opportunity to get rid of Pollard. And for that matter, Sunil Narine.
In the world game, we've seen the best of wrist spinners bowl at this phase of the innings. Not everyone does it. But Tabrez Shamsi is one such wrist spinner. He can bowl this phase. You think of Shadab Khan. Adam Zampa from Australia. Manindu Hasaranga from Sri Lanka. Adil Rashid from England.
Another one of those hashtags. We love a wristy.
Pollard might be saying the same at this stage of the innings. Got him! In Riste's reward, and he produces a rarial moment. Tabrez Shamsi, he's a champion bowler, not afraid to take on the best, and he conquers.
Queued up beautifully. Mention he's never got him out, but he has now. Again, the bravery to slow it down. Might have disappeared for two maximums, but Shamsi gets his man. Tremendous theatre here at the Queen's Park Oval. KP's got to go for a cameo 16 from 10, and it's 128 for 6 here.
Hussein, left-hand all-rounder, missed a few games because of injury. Of course, the last game he picked up his career best figures, 4 for 13. Pollard just playing across the line, deceived with the reduction in pace from that delivery. That's been the courageous thing about Tabrez Shamsi in this over. Not afraid to take pace off the ball. Not afraid to use his skills to good effect. Yeah.
And the Rispin twins. Great pictures.
Punch offside. And goes all the way for 6. Narine continues the fireworks.
Sea of red. 50 sixes to Sunil Narine and Hero CPL. What a time to do it. They really need this guy. Right here, right now. Oh, Larrifet over extra. You betcha.
So Narayan will only have one focus at this stage of the innings. Will try to hit every delivery on the ground. He'll be dealing in boundaries. Man on stilts, known as a Mukajambi in this part of the world.
Well, I've had a lot of tall timber that's come and gone in terms of reputation. Have TKR. I think when I look back at the innings and the responsibility of Andre Russell getting out when he did, it was a big, big moment in this clash. To get out so tamely when he really hadn't given himself a chance to get in and get set, given that he's a huge, huge asset, such a key to any side. Little review, we're going to come upstairs.
Paul trying to sneak an LBW at this late stage. He's into his fourth and final over, so they'll check and see if he oversteps. Always tight on that line. Looks as though something is behind the white line. Only just.
Once again, it's not a decoration. Stay behind the white line. So tight so often as well. Keep saying this. Kemo Paul. So often he's this tight now. Oh, just fractionally, just enough. Yeah. Give you that, Kemo.
It's around the wicket, so the angle is something that Dighton Butler has taken into consideration, hence he was not totally convinced. No edge on that occasion, ultra edge confirming same. Ball tracking will be the decider, Danny Morrison.
Well, just for me, look at that a couple of times with the naked eye. You think it's sliding because of that angle. Big angle, this right arm round, and I think it's missing. Yeah. Confirmation. So wide out on that return crease was Kemo Paul. So let's get on with it. And we do.
After a little pause, Kemo Paul will have to complete his remaining four deliveries.
Have I told you I like this place? The party, the biggest in sport, and played a little bit louder here. Gangers, I want to hear from you. I want you to cane it and make the roof come off.
I've heard it on countless occasions, Danny Morrison.
Oh, look, it's like a magnet. Alex Jordan. We'll have to get down there. Let's get down there to the posse stand.
You'll get your moment, Danny Morrison. Stay calm, stay calm.
It's just like no other. We keep saying this every time we come back to the Queen's Park Oval under lights with TKR playing.
Well, over number 18 had a face-off that was quite intriguing. Karen Pollard making a statement with two hero maximums early up. A little bit of byplay, yeah. Clash of egos. And just one winner.
Ah, love it. Love this game. Massive.
That's the type of contest you want to see within a game. Sheldon C. Narayan, part of this Trinbago Knight Riders. Seam Colin Board to the left. Sheldon Cenarine in his 100th CPL match.
Colin's got no nails left. He's aged a bit too. Some of us have, of course. What a blessing.
Team manager and equipment personnel.
Directorship of TKR. Yeah, once again, it just adds to the whole theatre of Hero CPL, the characters that are around the franchises. Not just about the players, but those involved that love being here, genuinely love being involved in it.
Dinanath Ramnarayan, technical advisor to the Trinbago Knight Riders. Gopi is doing his analysis. Quiet end to the over, 12 runs coming from it, 140 for six. Six deliveries remaining in this innings. The Knight Riders will have a chance to push this 140 to maybe 155, 160. They will have their work cut out because he's flying high on confidence. Tabriz Shamsi, 2 for 26 from three, and two of his four overs in the last five overs of the innings. Here he goes. Starts for Wakil Hussain. Wide through that offside.
Yeah, this is where they really do miss Pollard. Outthought, outdone by Shamsi. Tahir did that to Andre Russell.
Testing the batting skills of Wakil Hussain. It's not easy to hit the ball with power through the offside. It requires more top hand and not bottom hand. Having that is not a common quality in batters today. Only the very best could dominate through the offside with power. Will it be the same for Narayan in terms of plans? Three within the 30-yard circle, behind point. There's a deep cover, a long off. Big gap through that cover region.
Difference is, Narayan is set here. He's 26 from 19. Hit two maximums. Seeing it quite good tonight.
Yeah! Goes for the reverse. And the stumping is effected. Klaassen thinks he has his man. Umpires might just want to check and confirm. But they're already celebrating.
Yeah, he's got too cute here. Sunil Narayan knows he wanted to switch hit here up against Shamsi, challenging to say the least, and he is content to stroll off. He'll know if there's nothing planted behind. Goes early. Yeah, that foot on the line, or is it just outside of what's happened? Is it in the air? Oh yeah, do-si-do your partner with the dance shoes on. Got the wrong shoes on there, Sunil. Goes for 26, and the Knight Riders are 142 for seven.
Another lefty. Swung away, onside. There is a man in front of square. Still on the line with the feel. Knew exactly the line that Chamsey was going to bowl, so he opted for that reverse sweep. Another common shot for him, not a common shot. The execution wasn't right yet. She's shocked and surprised.
Gold replay and reaction. More Venus flytraps. It's been that sort of innings for TKR fans.
Slapped and should be taken. Hetmeyer gets in the way, completes the catch, gives a fourth wicket to the left arm wrist spinner Tabriz Shamsi. He's taking full control of this innings with the ball.
Yeah, it's again that beautiful pace. There's that turn and that flight, slowing the ball down. Well done, Skip. Marvellous. Judged it to perfection. Get the shoe off. Shamsa, well done. Oh, Celebration City here tonight for the Warriors. Just want to check the fair catch. Just make absolutely certain that Shimon Hetmeyer's got his fingers underneath it and taken it. Process tight, but okay. No problems there. But yeah, once again, the pace, so shrewd, so smart. I think he's got his fingers underneath that. See, and also, you see that normal real-time motion. You can often see a guy get his fingers underneath it a bit better. But this will give us a good gauge as well. Fingers underneath. Straight in. 100%. Happy chappy. See you later. Hussain. They'll have to give it. Is it? Titus, have you? Yes. See you. See you later, Hussain. 143 for 8.
New batter already out in the middle. Is this a 5-4 or a 6-4? It is. And here a maximum Rampal nails it off the middle of the bat.
Ravi Rampal. 6 left-handers in the side. There's another one. What a wonderful connection from the big fella. Yeah, swings hard and gets enough of it.
Have thought this is the highest score for TKR this season. Rampal goes for a single, tries to complete the second. They decide against it. Only one to close the innings. Knight Riders getting to that 150 marker, and it's significant in the context of their batting and what we've seen from them this season. ...150 for 8, but it's Tabriz Shamsi who has really starred with the ball. 4 for 36 from his complement of 4, and Hetmeyer will also be very happy with this target.
Won the toss, wanted to go up front as a group bowl. I think if you ask them at the coin toss, Shimron Hetmeyer say, yep, yeah, I'll take that. I really will. To restrict the star-studded lineup of the Trinbago Knight Riders to 150 from their 20 here tonight, I think you'd take that every night of the week. Marvellous stuff in terms of restricting this gun side. Look at Webster, Porro, Munro, Seifert, Russell. Soon on the right, and then Pollard himself further down the innings. And the top score from Colin Munro of 42. There's a couple of 20s thrown in there as well, and a couple of scores in the teens. Shame for Nicholas Poran. and the fans that he couldn't get going after a little cameo.
And in terms of the Warriors bowling, well, Shamsi, star with the ball, 4 for 36. So too, Romario Shepherd, who started things off with that wicket off the first ball. He picked up 3 with a solid economy of 7.3. Young Sinclair looked good on debut. He bowled a few tough overs. But collectively, they've excelled, the Warriors. Kimo Paul, wicketless, but good economy. Imran Tahir, his 1 for 19. Always economical and threatening. Let's now join Tanvi Shah.
I have with me Colin Munro. Colin, after that first start to the innings, that was rough, but you came in on the second ball. Did you feel the pressure of expectations from the crowd?
No, I don't think so. I've played here many a year now, so I feel the love here at the stadium. So just go out there, play my natural game.
Well, if we've been seeing the last couple games, the scores have been somewhere between the 130 to 140 range. You guys are the highest. What do you think the surface is playing like?
Surface is playing okay. There's an area from bowling from this pavilion end down that way, staying a little bit low, so the bowlers just have to hit the right length. And then from the other side, it looks like a good pitch. So 150 is probably 10 or 15 short where we want it to be. But hopefully the bowlers, now we've got our keel back, can start with the new ball and we see how we go.
Well, what do you think you guys have to do to defend this? I mean, 150.
Yeah, I just think it's got to be the same. We've brought some energy in the field. I think we can lift in the field a little bit more and start with the ball really well. That's where we've just been missing a little bit. But we've got a score on the board now and we've got to go out there and defend it.
And with the entire crowd behind you, how amazing does it feel and how energetic?
Okay.
Well, good luck to you and good luck to the rest of the team.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tanvi Shah. Interesting thoughts from Colin Munro on the pitch. If you missed the action, well, it was quite eventful from the start. Nicholas Puran, Tion Webster opening the batting for the Knight Riders. The first ball, there was an appeal. An umpire, Nigel Duguid, raised the dreaded finger. Tion Webster had to go for a diamond duck. Munro came in at number 3. And he blossomed with Nicholas Puran. They both put on 31. Puran in particular took the attack to Shepherd, and then the last ball off the power play, he nicked one behind. That left Munro and Tim Seifert to start building a partnership, and that they did.
Yeah, two Kiwis with a bit of communication, and he's so good there until there. Smart catch from Sterling, go-to area, and Shamsi with the celebration and the shoe-off. And then Tahir, he got the prize scalp of Andre Russell. Caught in the deep by Shepherd comfortably. And the celebration start with Imran Tahir. Oh, brilliant. And he had a bit of similar ride in terms of striking. Shepherd got his third. It was Seifert who just duffed us. It was a good catch in the end by Hetmeyer.
Yeah, Hetmeyer leading the way with catches in the field. Then that battle with Shamsi and Pollard. 2 sixes straight away. Then the wicket came. Degal from the left-arm wrist spinner. And he celebrated in style. So then the Ryan tried the reverse sweep. Found himself out of his crease. He was stumped in a smart way by Henrik Claassen. Hussein looking for a hero maximum. Gave Shamsi his fourth wicket. Another good catch from the Warriors captain. And the innings came to an end. 150 for 8. So at the halfway stage, the Warriors, they'll need 151 if they are to win this. Join us for the run chase after the break.
Every part, every deal, every wicket, every score. No passion, at the culture, Caribbean blues. When time come out all nation, to the team in a unification. When the stadium run beach at the grandstand, at the meaning of unification.
It's how we play. play.
Hero CPL match number 18 for 2022, live from the Queen's Park Oval here in Trinidad. The host side, Trinbago Knight Riders, up against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. They were sent into bat, were the home side. Didn't start well. Teon Webster out very early on. Nicholas Puran, 15 from 7. Munro, the standout, 42 from 37. That partnership with Tim Seifert taking the score from 31 to 82. And a little cameo from Sunil Narine at the back end as well. Colin Munro, 42 from 37 with 5 fours. It was hard work. It looked like a tough surface to pick up the pace on and to score runs on consistently. He hung in there, did a decent job for his team. Time will tell whether 150 is enough, but I think it's competitive if TKR's bowlers get everything right, as some of these guys did. Romario Shepherd, excellent tonight, 3 for 22. Imran Tahir was very tidy. Kimo Paul, I thought, bowled nicely as well without reward. And Tabrez Shamsi went for nines, but 4 for 36. Nice to see Romario Shepherd back amongst the wickets. Ian Bishop alongside.
You're a hard worker, and he's been getting better and better with his bowling up front and in the middle overs. And given what he went through in that game against the Talawas and then the Patriots, he's shown great heart and great character.
Yeah, wicket balls, one full toss, one decent sort of a length, I think, and then the other one was slightly fuller, but Nicholas Puran chased it and just got the outside edge through to Heinrich Klaassen, who took a really good catch. And a bit of class shown from former world number one T20 bowler as well, Bush, and Tabrez Shamsi.
Great control, great awareness, his ability to absorb pressure and then get the length right against Pollard and then against Narine, and the catching of Shimron Hetmeyer down in that hot spot on Hetmeyer's shoulders and being able to utilize his trump card.
Yeah, very good from Shamsi tonight. Dream 11 Fantasy League scoreboard sees Tabrez Shamsi right at the top on 100 points. Romario Shepherd, 99. Will he be required with the bat to maybe get himself above Shamsi? And then Munro, Narine and Tahir rounding out the Dream 11 Fantasy leaderboard for match 18. That is the points earned after innings number one. And remember that there is only one innings gone at the moment. Kyron Pollard will be having a word to his troops, I'm sure, telling them that we must defend it. Crowd have been fantastic. They've been unbelievably good. And we are in a fantastic part of the world that celebrate not only cricket, but so much more, Ian Bishop.
Yeah, you can go to the North Coast and Maracas Beach, which has been redeveloped over the years. It's a hot spot, and particularly when it comes to the holiday periods in Trinidad and Tobago, it's packed to capacity. It's a drive to get there, a scenic drive through the hills of Navan Range.
Well, the Trinbago Knight Riders will be hoping this crowd, who are right in behind their team tonight, make the drive in a couple of days' time as well for the weekend to the Brian Lara ground, where we will be Saturday and Sunday evening for TKR matches, plus games in the morning at 10 a.m. as well, Saturday and Sunday. So we've got to get this one out of the way first and foremost. Hero have been wonderful sponsors for 8 years now of the Hero CPL. Look forward to taking one of those bikes for a ride, actually, in Guyana when I get there. Paul Sterling hasn't had the start to the tournament that he would have wanted. Chandrapal Hemraj. We'll take the new ball. Economy rate of 6.633. Three wickets and couple of matches for the Pavilion. And his boundary riders will be at backward point and deep backward square for the right-handed Paul Sterling on strike. He's dangerous. And how much would the Guyana Amazon Warriors love to see him get underway tonight? Let's play indeed. The player, Paul Sterling, is vastly experienced, over 200 games. International games of cricket for Ireland. No run.
Yeah, he is good square of the wicket on the pull, the cut, the punch. I like the aggression in the approach to the crease of Pavilion as well. He runs in hard, he attacks the crease. He bowled a nice full length the other night. He picked up a couple of wickets, but we saw in St. Lucia when he hits the ball into the surface, he can get some reward. And as you rightly said, he's up against a good player in Sterling.
This has gone high. Russell should get there and will get there and takes it comfortably. Dropped on the other night, big grey Russ. Not tonight. Pavilion strikes.
Got the crowd going. Yeah, it's a similar type of catch that Dre Russ put down. He was moving back just a little bit wide of off stump, and it looked like it swung away a touch. Great coverage from Dre Russ this time, and he's enjoyed that. He has bowled well. Good to see him getting some reward early. Sterling goes, none for one.
Cross, so Chandrapal Hemraj is the man on strike, and the experienced players keep coming. Colin Ingram is out in the middle now because of this right bish, just the swing. He reached for it, he got right on the toe end of the bat, knew straight away it was going to Dre Russ, and he wasn't going to make that same mistake twice.
Good away movement. I thought it was a little bit, it was significant actually. One for one. And one more. Jaden Steele's got me there. He was running to the other end and taking his cap off, eager to bowl from the other end.
I'm the one that's been used to five ball overs, Besh, not you.
All right, it's a set. One set gone.
Nicely punched off the back foot, but excellent start for the TKR men. It is now one for one. I've had some wonderful shots from our Omega XL Skycam. It was on its way up when Paul Sterling was dismissed. Picked up Andre Russell, moving back. And a great start for this TKR side, who were desperate for a win. And the crowd as well, who have been magnificent. Jaden Seals. That's with a wide.
Bit of pressure on Jaden Seals in that they started, I think, with Ravi Rampol last night, and he went for quite a few runs against Kyle Mayers, pulling and cutting him. Now Seals has to move, shift his line over towards the off stump. And Pollard has to also, I think, anyway, to be very quick in going to who are his best bowlers, especially with the ball getting damp quickly. Narine and Akil Hussain must be also at the forefront of his thoughts before the ball gets soaked and greasy.
Punched off the back foot for at least two. Timing is impeccable, and it's going to be four. That is a wonderful piece of timing.
High quality shot that will have a couple of effects. One, it's brought up the boundary, but two, it's run across a very moist outfield and would have absorbed some of that moisture. It's beautifully played though. I wonder how much if I must see come in my length without over pitching along that same line.
The leg side again. Yeah, look, I get the feeling watching Chandrapal Hemraj, he's more comfortable on the back foot at times, and so bringing him forward is not a bad option. Could have a straightish mid-off, could stay on the circle and be a little bit straighter, and my cover could come a little bit straighter as well. And I don't mind making him drive one or two. I think it was relatively damp throughout the Amazon Warriors innings as well, wasn't it? We saw the rags out a lot. Still saw Shamsi though operating late in the piece, so I guess that's a sign that they kept it relatively dry when they could. And it was changed, I remember once at least, it may be twice, Bish.
Attacking length and line, and you want to be able to try to get another wicket in this power play to try to set things up, because the Warriors generally bat deep. Kimo Paul, Odine Smith, Romario Shepherd, not necessarily in that order. Junior Sinclair offers pretensions as a capable order batter.
Mm-hmm. high, very high indeed. It's an opportunity again down at long leg. Oh dear, just got himself all crossed up and mixed up in the end. And puts it down, 10 for 1. Been his best night, John Webster.
He backed off, then realized he backed off too much and then had to get forward. Not straightforward, a steepler. That'll be disappointing nevertheless.
High in the air, as you said, Bishop. You're right, he just circled a little bit, then went back and had to reach. It's so difficult to do that. Comes away over backward point for 1. To think that Bago Knight Riders need to hold those, they need to hold every catch. 150 on the board, time will tell whether that is good enough or not. You don't want to be letting players like Chanderpaul Hemraj or Ingram get away on you, give them extra chances.
Sterling had his hands full against Dupavillon, attacking the stumps initially, and then got one wide above stump and curling away from him. Which ended up eliciting that strike low down on the bat and getting height and no distance.
Hard down the ground, that'll be 4 more. On the up.
Yeah, Hemraj looks to be in an ultra positive mood, hitting through the line of the ball. He's a dangerous customer. You may have to change up your pace a little bit to him, even in the power play. Change up your length as well.
Full toss. Is it over? Just over the head of mid-off. It's a terrific effort. Way to the boundary, so back-to-back 4s.
Yeah, can't fault Jaden Seals on that occasion, but the type of flying start, having had the chance that the Amazon Warriors want.
driven again, or just about back onto the stumps. He got a little hand on that to Pavillon. End of the third over, 21 for one. Good awareness from Colin Ingram on that occasion. Test comes, but it shouldn't be one. They've got to be better than that inside the circle. Circle.
Yeah, there are two teams who struggle with their opening combinations, isn't it? The TKR averaged 10 this season prior to this match, the Warriors 15 before this match.
Worst run rate in the power play as well, just to back up what you're saying, Ian Bishop. 5.61. They're the only team under six inside the power play. What Chandrapal Hemraj has done is forced Kyron Pollard into Bowlingson on the right inside, and with two left-handers there, I think he'd be reluctant to bring Akil Hussain in as well.
Sitting here thinking the same thing for a couple of deliveries. I see Ravi Rampol getting loose at square leg, so maybe he is in the running, Rampol, to take over from Dupavillon.
Tidy start from Sunil Narine, just the three coming from it, 24 for one at the end of four.
Barbados Royals lead proceedings in the power play, and sometimes I wonder, we've talked them up, but I wonder if we've given the Royals enough credit for the excellence that they've displayed across the board this season, with some of the focus on some of the, I suppose, bigger followings of teams. The Royals have been outstanding across departments and deserve a lot of credit so far for what they've done. Rampo.
Over a wide-ish backward point, and one bounce into the boundary for four. Throwing the bat at some width here, Hemraj.
under pressure straight away. Ravi Rampol went for 24 in his first two overs last night in the previous game. And sometimes those wide deliveries can bring a result, but as a bowler, you want to start on a tight off stump and a good length. He was too short and too wide, getting hit both sides of the pitch last night.
Pulls this time, that's excellent work. Fantastic. Jaden Seals, is it? At mid on, he's a good athlete. On Barbados though, Bish, their issue will be, can they keep it up when they lose two key left-handers? And I know we talk about this, but when after this leg we feel like Quinton de Kock and David Miller will have to disappear, and that is a massive blow to the Royals camp. I'm guessing Kyle Mayers will take over the captaincy. He did it in the 60 instead of Jason Holder, which, I mean, two very good options, no issue with that, but their job will be to keep it up. And when do they have their little slip up? That's in the gap, that one. Chase for Seals. He's quick, but he's not quick enough.
Looks like it might have been a little bit of pace off and good ball striking from Hemraj, barring the drop catch. Has looked to play very positively. Curious to see how they go as well, the Amazon Warriors, with their spin combination. Brian Tahir will stay, so when they get to Guyana and more familiar conditions to some of them like Hemraj, how they can go with that crowd support.
Shakib Al Hassan comes in, so it's not a bad replacement. It's not quite the Shamsi like for like, but it'll give them more batting and another quality left arm spinner. Cloth straight to Seals, out. Good pace from Ravi Rampol, just hurrying Hemraj a touch.
Jaden Seals, who had his opportunity to get rid of Hemraj earlier, gleefully takes the catch. So the short ball has been punished sometimes from Rampol. This time it works in his favor. It's a quick fire 28 though from Hemraj, 34 for 2.
Henrik Claassen is come out to join Colin Ingram in the middle. Last ball of Rampol's over. Short again, and Claassen will be off the mark with a single. Fifth over, 35 for 2.
Thank you.
Time for Akil Hussain, left arm spinner. Only his second game in Hero CPL 2022. Career best 4 for 13 in that first game. He is within the power play, the last over of the power play. Concedes a Hero maximum. What a welcome for Akil Hussain. Klaassen continues where he left off from his last innings. Good night, Samuel Badri.
Hello, Darren. Hello, everyone. Short from Akil Hussain first up. I'm given the treatment. Really loose delivery. Not very often we see that from Akil Hussain. It was, as you mentioned, the coming to this team because the Trinbago Knight Riders are under pressure.
And again. Flies all the way for six. Aaron Pollard, the TKR captain, was given chase. But what a start to the innings for Klaassen.
Yeah, some pyrotechnics from Klaassen and some acrobatics from Kyron Pollard. Consecutive sixes to start the final over of the power play. Kyron Pollard just hopping forward roll and gets up in the end. Yeah, they're having a laugh, but it's no laughing matter now for the Trinbago Knight Riders, for Akil Hussain in particular. How does he respond?
He's put pressure on Akil Hussain in recent times, as was mentioned. Spent a lot of time off the field because of his groin injury. Now he's back. And again. Brings up the 54, the Warriors. This is a different outlook from the Warriors in the power play.
It seems as though Klaassen is batting on a completely different surface altogether. Another Hero maximum, make that three in the over. Again, the length, a little bit on the shorter side, but absolutely smashed. Head down, looking at the ball, good bat swing, good follow through. Look at the eyes from Klaassen. A lot of discussion from Nikuran Singh, and again, they're under pressure. What a start for Henrik Klaassen. 19 from 5. For six, short, whacked over deep mid wicket. A little bit fuller. Lots of height, enough distance. And then the final one, or the last one rather, might not be the final one.
After three sixes, he falls to Akil Hussain. That's a huge wicket for the Knight Riders. Anticlimactic end to the innings for Klaassen.
Yeah, the sea of red, they're on their feet, they're celebrating. Not the best delivery, short and wide, but didn't get the elevation that he was looking for. Nicholas Puran doesn't miss out. What a recovery for Akil Hussain. Yeah, just a little bit of a send-off as well. Cameo comes to an end. 19 from 6, 53 for 3.
what a spicy affair. Trinbago Knight Riders, Guyana Amazon Warriors. And the captain, Shimron Hetmeyer. At the crease, within the power play. Just one delivery to end this phase of the innings. Quite an eventful over so far. Three hero maximums, then the wicket of Clarkson. He's just trying to power the ball through the offside, get the elevation. Didn't get pace on the ball, maybe a bit of grip too from the surface. Yeah, just giving an indication that it held in the surface. Trinbago Knight Riders quickly into this Warriors batting lineup. Paul Stirling was dismissed without scoring. Chandrapal Himraj, after a few nice strokes, he fall to Rampal. The last wicket out of Clarkson, on to Hussain. Required rate just under 7 at the moment.
Yeah, and the current run rate 9. So what they're doing well is that they're scoring healthily. They just lost those 3 wickets. That knock from Clarkson, 19 from 6. That's the sort of momentum-changing knock that you look for in T20 cricket.
In the gap for 4. He's so easy on the eyes, Shimron Hetmeyer. And he's a natural stroke maker. Finds the gap with ease, and he does so on this occasion.
Yeah, very elegant and graceful. Just a matter of pure timing, good placement, and then gets the boundary. And 5 from 2, Colin Ingram. He's 4 from 9. He needs to get going or keep that momentum. Think back to Tim Seifert, who scored 27 from 35 deliveries through the middle period. That stymied the progress of the Trinbago Knight Riders.
Hetmeyer form quite good in Hero CPL 2022. 39 against the Talawas. 46 against the Patriots. 32 against the Kings.
It's the first time the Warriors have reached 50 in the power play in the CPL, so good start on that count. But the 3 wickets, that's the concern.
Colin Ingram just playing a supporting role at the moment. Hasn't really found the going easy in Hero CPL. Had 6 in that last innings against the Kings, so his lack of productivity with the bat will be weighing on his mind. Coming off a county stint with Glamorgan. Off the inside edge. Wasn't intended, but Hetmeyer will take it.
Yeah, fortuitous for Shimron Hetmeyer, Warrior Nation. They'll be celebrating this. Doesn't matter how these runs come. It could have gone easily onto the stump. Instead, it goes to the boundary. All along the ground. No luck for Rampal on that occasion. With the 2 left-handers at the crease. You think that Sullen and Ryan will be bowling the next couple overs from the pavilion end. maybe looking at having a slip or someone in a catching position and need to continue to take wickets, the Knight Riders.
Watching this field and felt that that vacant deep wicket was an area that Shimron Hetmyer will be targeting. It's a natural stroke for him for deliveries that are short and which allows him to swivel and pull through the onside. That's a concern for Rampol. His length has to be a little bit fuller to Hetmyer. And for the pull shot, not quite coming off the middle of the bat. 10 runs from the over, 7 gone, 64 for 3. Atmosphere at the Queen's Park Oval, a sea of red, but pensive look on the faces of the Knight Riders supporters. Narine for his second over. I like to see a slipping position or someone in a catching position forcing on the line, even a bat pad, a forward throw, like something to look to get a wicket. This is your premier spinner. You need wickets. Healthy run rate at the moment for the Amazon Warriors over 9. Just don't want him bowling through these overs and being economical without taking a this. They look to just nudge him around, keep him out of the game. Candidate for a hero fan of the match.
Oh!
Ryan just taking hit by a little bit wider outside that off stump.
Sensible batting from Hetmyer, 2 deliveries left in the over. Just look to nudge it for a single, get off strike, just like that. Negate the wicket taking threat off Narine. And they can bat the 4 overs or the 2 overs remaining from Narine well. They're almost there.
Interesting period of the game with Hetmyer at the crease with Colin Ingram. Munro with the ball, surprisingly.
Whitmire straight away wants two. He'll get four. Two bonus runs. That was timed sweetly. The placement was also excellent.
Yeah, disappointing from Jaden Seals. Almost sums up the effort from the Trinbago Knight Riders in this campaign to date. Relatively simple take for the young man. Missed it completely. Tion Webster dropped the catch. Another couple, no, just one. Much better this time from Jaden Seals. And you mentioned, I think it was yesterday, Darren, about the structure of this Trinbago Knight Riders team. Again, we're seeing some unpredictability, which sometimes is good. But Colin Munro bowling in this situation, just don't understand what's the thinking behind that. When we look at the batting order that they've sent as well, hasn't really inspired any sort of confidence. So a team that is full of experience, full of stars, full of quality, not getting it right. Well, it's the first time he's bowling in 2 years. He's got 31 T20 wickets. Trying to figure out the rationale behind the use of Colin Munro at this stage of the innings. Face off the ball. That's what Karen Pollard is looking for. Pollard himself has done a good job with the ball. Still feel the option of an Andre Russell is a viable option if you're looking to contain the opposition and to get wickets using seam. I don't think Colin Munro is going to trouble Hetmeyer. And it's something that you've spoken about incessantly. The left-hand orthodox bowler, Akil Hussain. Yes, it's two left-handed batsmen, but you can't overthink that and overplay that and keep him out of the game. He is a quality bowler. It doesn't matter if it's right-hand or left-hand at the crease. Get him inside, get him involved, and look for a wicket. That's what you need. Just can't understand this thinking and strategy from the Knight Riders at this stage. Ten runs from the over without too many risks. 78 for three after nine. Always committed to the cause, bringing you these lovely images from the Queen's Park Oval, nestled in the capital city here in Port of Spain. City at night, lights on, action at the Queen's Park Oval. Warriors, they need 73 more from 66 balls. Willie Dazzle with the ball. Here's Andre Russell. Yeah, they're still trying to get him into this tournament. Hasn't gotten into it with the bat. Can he get into it with the ball? Russell. How can Karen Pollard prize a wicket in the circumstances? This partnership growing, 26 from 20. Growing without having to take too many risks. Now there is a winner, an Angostura chill, refreshing moment winner.
with his straw hat, loving life, loving cricket too. Well done.
Yeah, it's clearly a Trinbago Knight Riders supporter with his merchandise, his official jersey, and I wonder if he will trade that award with a win for the Knight Riders. Really desperate for some points. Both these teams, as a matter of fact, one of them will leapfrog the St. Lucia Kings.
Now listen to Colin Munro at the halfway stage, and he spoke about when bowling from the pavilion end, there's an area on the pitch. If you find that area, the bounce is a little bit inconsistent. He said it kept a little bit low on occasion, so that's something that Andre Russell might be thinking with the start of this spell. The Amazon Warriors fans in the house.
It's a little bit deceptive, isn't it? Because it's majority red with their supporters' t-shirt and similar with the Trinbago Knight Riders. But what is unmistakable is that flag. The golden arrow of the Guyana national flag being waved lustily here at the Queen's Park Oval. Well and truly on top, but lots to play, lots of ebbs and flows in this game still. Up and away, chance. Confirmation of the legality of this delivery from Andrew Russell. Yeah, seems to be good. First point of contact behind the line, importantly, and not enough pace on it to get it past the fielder at third. Relatively simple catch. And a wicket for Andrew Russell. Captain goes, Hetmeyer goes. 20 from 16, 81 for 4.
And we'll now have some refreshment in the Angostura chill moment.
For right, could it be good enough for the Red Sea that's here at the Queen's Park Oval? Stirling, well, he thought he'd get on with it inside the power play, blew it. Andre Russell holds on and celebrates, and then Hemraj duffed it. Ravi loved it. Passing, just hit three sixes. Nikhil Hussain had his man, had his say. And then the skipper's just ramp this. Another night that might just go a bit squarer or maybe just a bit finer, but not tonight for Shimron Etmeyer. And he came second. Gone for 20. So Klaassen and Hetmeyer got little cameos but couldn't kick on. Russell just finishing out this 10th at the drinks break. So at 10, it's 81 for 4. As it bounces, it bouncer gets big on him. Simon Dool, not a bad delivery.
Good from Dre Russ. He needed something, his team needed something. Big wicket of Shimron Hetmeyer. Ingram is struggling along, 12 from 18, so it's a really good wicket. They bat deep, Dream 11 Fantasy leaderboard. This is the points earned after 10 overs of the second innings. Romario Shepherd may have a part to play with the bat yet, so he could usurp Tabrez Shamsi at the top of that board. Munro won't have any more to say apart from maybe a catch or two.
And the party is still amping along here. They believe, they always believe, those in red and black, given it's here at this venue. Hemo Paul out in the middle now.
Yeah!
Oh, knocked over! We've just had a drinks break, funnily enough, in T20. You can't hang around anymore, Chemo. Poles are everywhere. And Kyron's just telling him, that means you're out. Cheerleaders are saying you're out as well. See you later, Chemo.
Yeah, rightly so. It was an awful shot. Wasn't there to be pulled. Just get it on. I mean, it's hit halfway up, three quarters of the way up at the most. First ball, very first ball. Not sure what he was thinking there, Chemo Paul, but Akil Hussain, after copping some treatment early from Heinrich Klaassen, has bounced back with a double. Paul gone without scoring, 81 for 5.
Should be playing for United. Romario Shepherd. Now that's how you do it, Chemo Paul. Just keep it nice and simple and work it around for your team. Yeah. Yeah, Dooley, hard to know what he was thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, just didn't. I mean, Corin Pollard might have been having a word in his ear, but he didn't say a thing. Didn't have to say a thing.
Absolutely. Yeah, more celebration. He got rid of Klaassen. Now he's got rid of Chemo Paul. Suddenly half the side out. 69 from 58. Might only be just over sevens, but all of a sudden, a bit more tension around. They'll be thinking, thank goodness we've got a little bit of Colin Ingram out there just to keep it calm. It's bold, stands there. Let's see how long it takes. Clock has started. Colin's going, mate, an inning game of cricket, that's out. The thing stuck in the ground gets removed, you're out of here. Oh, classic. It's nice and fine. Mario's helped himself to a nice little tickle here. Much needed runs for the Warriors.
Well, it just takes some sensible batting from here on in, really. It's 64 off 56. There's no absolute scoreboard pressure. Seven runs and over, you think, with Romario Shepherd, with Odin Smith. The junior Sinclair's okay as well. Opportunities present themselves, but they just need a little partnership. TKR, though, they have to believe they're still in it. Pick up Ingram and then put the pressure on the big all-rounders.
Oh, yes, boy, yes, boy.
It's better from Akeel, attacking those stumps. You still can't believe it. Give that gum a workout, Chief. And relax. Seems very easy up here. It's a bit of sense and sensibility. We've got the bingo score. Two fat ladies for five after 11. Assassin. There's Colin Ingram just quietly going about his business. That's all that's required. A little bit of a level head. He's come in at first drop and he's seen a few of his mates go. And, Dooley just looking at overs here left. Duke Pavilion has a couple. Seals, been a bit off. It's one about some of these players. You've said it a bit over this last past couple of weeks or so, just saying, where are these guys at with their headspace? What's going on with them to front up?
Yeah, and what, you know, what's going through that mind at different times as well? And where are they at as far as this tournament is concerned? They're not always easy to be up and on it. Paid good money to do it. One more game here at Queen's Park Oval tomorrow. That is a morning game, 10 a.m. encounter. Barbados Royals up against the Jamaica Talawas. Match 19 before we have a day off and then head north, I think, is it? South. The other direction. The other north. South.
We haven't even had a day off yet.
To the Brian Lara Cricket Academy.
Let's get on that boat again on Friday. Oh, we've got to. I think we're going south on that. But right here this evening, 63 from 54, very comfortable.
Oh, yes, Sonny boy!
Oh, another one that just keeps a little low from Sunil Narayan. Have to be watchful here, Shepherd. A lot of responsibility on those big broad shoulders now to hang in. Oh, it's one of those ones you can chop on so easily.
Oh.
Better, better. Slippers in. Now hunting up here. They have to with Narayan.
Yeah, this is all about putting a little bit of scoreboard pressure back on. Nicholas Plourat, every ball, walking in there, trying to. He's pretending that he's basically drying his hands off, but he's getting in there of Romario Shepherd.
Still got an over to go after this. This is where you have your big guns come in, get to the bowling crease and winkle a wicket here. Really do need another one. Dearly love to have the Warriors six down in the next, 4 to 5 runs. Be magical. Crowd get involved. Just erupt. And all of a sudden, it's a different ball game again. That experience of Colin Ingram, been around the scene a long time now, played a lot of franchise T20. Oh, there we go! Party time! Crank it up! Listen to the place erupt!
Yeah, looking for the sweep shot, got a little bit of glove and it's popped up. Siphon quickly onto it, runs around, picks up the catch, and TKR faithful find their voice again, back of the glove, Seifert really quickly onto that. Comfortable in the end. Narine picks another for the CPL 2022. And this time it's Ingram that goes. 13 from 20. Further trouble for the Amazon Warriors. 89 for 6.
Boxes are out in the middle, and they need a heavyweight partnership here, because just want to look at this. It just bounced a little bit more. Oh, a little bit early too. Got to give some kudos to Sunil Narine. Just held it back fractionally more. Celebration City. Oh yeah.
Yeah!
And no surprise as everyone clears their lungs. Nigel says no. Asian still seems so comfortable, but we've lost another wicket for Warriors fans.
Like this from Kyron Pollard, good captaincy. A lot of pressure on these two now.
Oh, there you go! It is happening here! El Dorado celebration. Zach Collin, get back in your seat! They won't! Everyone's out of them! Oh, sea of red.
Well, the pressure's getting to the Guyana Amazon Warriors here. This is just a, dare I say it, a filthy hoy across the line from Odin Smith. Got to be better than that. He knows the pressure. Last ball of the over from Sunil Narine. And what an over it has been. Two wickets for one. Oh, let's check. Let's check the front foot. Let's check the front foot, Sonny. Get something down. Oh, no. Oh, dear me. Oh, wow. I think it's okay. I think it's okay. If that heel's behind the line when it comes down, it doesn't have to be on the ground. As long as you draw a straight line down the back of the heel, you're okay. We'll give him that one. Odin Smith departs. It's another duck. Yeah, drop the bat, kick the bat, and away you go. 89 for 7.
Straight, as you don't worry about that, spinners are going to give it a bit of hang time. Junior Sinclair's out there because of this explosion from Odin Smith. 4 wickets and 14 balls. You look at it, 2 fell at 81 and now 2 falling at 89. He's absolutely ruptured this Warriors innings. Ticking along so comfortably at 3 for 81. Extraordinary. Pollard, no surprises. Helmet on, get in the face. Have a bit to say with a slip in as well.
Yeah!
Oh, you're kidding me. Now, I'd have to bowl going for a stumping. Just from the naked eye way up here, I thought it was poles disrupted again. But it's going for a stumping, Timmy Seifert.
Wow, it's turning as well. This is beautiful flight, swing and a miss. Everything all right there with Romario Shepherd, no problem at all with the foot. But lovely bowling from Akil Hussain.
Catch!
And he went for 19 in his first over. Klaassen got hold of him with those three sixes. Now he's got two for 26. Oh, red. Red, red, red. Moi. Oh, again. Again, careful, Shep. Oh. Hugs and kisses to this extraordinary theatre that is the Queen's Park Oval. Oh, yes. Now, some nerves around here for Junior Sinclair. On debut, he comes out at number 9. Look out. He's off the mark to hold on to the strike. It's 91 for 7.
Just for you, Dan.
The Carnival. You picked it. Hero fan of the match. That is simply outstanding. A lot of work involved with this. Talk about passion. Bringing your colours to the stadium. Well done. Brilliant. Well done, sir. Need a long shower to get that all off. Well done, though. Brilliant. 500 US. The hero fan of the match. Well, it's Dre Russ. He's got a wicket, he's got the prize scale for the skipper. 1 for 3 from 1. And Kyron Pollard's gone back to him. I tell you, the most wickets in Hero CPL, DJ Bravo, no surprises. You all would have got that in the quiz. 119. Rayad Emirate, 96. And now soon on the right joins Rayad Emirate in Hero CPL with the most wickets in this marvellous tournament. But he's been replaced by Dre Russ.
Rayad Emirate. Look at the matches for Rayad Emirate as well. Just 85 for those 96 wickets. He was a clever operator. Krishmar Santoki. Good numbers for him as well. He's playing in the old man's tournament at the moment, actually in India. Krishmar Santoki, the left armer. Jamaican, and played a lot for the Amazon Warriors, didn't he? Santoki.
You say those old names, surely he should still be playing. Little cutters. No, Andre. Just need to keep it simple. Yeah, holds his hand. Crowd, well, we keep saying it. Really is. A sea of red, an amazing place to watch, particularly night cricket. They come out in their droves, they get dressed up. Our hero fan of the match. Oh, it is a great sight. It really is. Passion like no other. Last 30 balls. Here's a stat for you. 20 runs, but 4 wickets. That's all. Man, have they fallen into a hole here. Not about winning as a habit. Well, so's losing. Both these sides want to get out of this rut. Celebration. Dre Russ making up for his batting with the bowling.
Yeah, spot on. Gets the Yorker on the money. And with Romario Shepherd, possibly goes the last hopes for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. On pace and rips it underneath the bat of the big man Shepherd, and he takes off. And TKR in front of their local, and their vociferous supporters look like they might be coming away with a couple of points tonight. Not over yet, but they're well and truly on their way as Shepherd goes for just 8 and 93 for 8 now.
Nuvi Imranta here, can't blame him. Probably feels he shouldn't be out there. His mates should have done the job. They certainly haven't here tonight. Cracking Yorker. Yeah, star quality on stage, front and centre. Andre Russell pulls out a beauty. Tall man, get underneath it. He can't, he's so late on it. Wow. Takeoff from Dre Russ. Ah, brilliant. Oh, brilliant. That is a great stroke. There's the wizard Gandalf. Got the shaft out and said, yeah, there's a beauty for you.
Yeah, clever from Imran Tahir. Just a little uppercut. Well done.
That's classic. So T20. Well played, sir. 43 years young. Stats gurus have just told me. Only his second boundary in CPL for the great Imran Tahir. Amazon Warriors in danger of being bowled out for their lowest total ever against TKR at this very venue in 2018. It was 103. It's now 97 for 8. So the last 30 balls, 19 for 5. They're having an absolute ball in the stands here at the Queen's Park Oval. Once again, the youngster going to rotate it.
He's actually shown a little bit of composure. I know he's only 3. Yeah, there he is. Shamsi supporter. Shoes off. Shoe phone on.
Just Shams to come. I wonder if he'll come out with his phone. Out the bat. Let's get him out here. Hurry up, get Shamsi out here. Gil Hussain. He's 2 for 29, left arm orthodox. Yeah, he won't mind this. He's just giving it a nice bit of flight. Wants it to spin, wants it to turn and bring perhaps the keeper and Nicholas Poran and slip into play, and maybe even Pollard, a little bat pad. Pollard hunting up, having a wee chat. Big barn door at Sillimut off.
Well, I must say at times there has been some average batting, some ordinary batting, but it does show you on the surface that if you put a score on the board, 150, it is defendable. A fought their way to 150. The TKR, they certainly haven't been at their best still. They've managed to get there, they've found a way to get there, and on the back of a couple of good performances with the ball, a couple of rash shots from the Guyana Amazon Warriors, they might pick up a couple of points. 100 comes up, 8 down.
Composure needed, 150 on the board. Shows you you're in the game.
Yes!
Oh, you wouldn't have scripted it. Just put around the corner and pull. will take the celebrations. Yep. Four over the catch, but put that down to the skipper and the bowler, setting it up beautifully.
Welcome back, Ducky Hussain. Back into the team tonight after missing a few games with injury. This one off the inside edge. Nicholas Puran takes a comfortable catch, and all of a sudden, nine down and on the brink of victory. TKR, is this the life they needed in the tournament to get them back in amongst it? Tahir gone for five, nine down for 100.
Delivery left for Akil Hussain. Last man standing. Shamsi. Well, there'll be another delivery for Hussain. Out with injury for 12, 13 days. And has come back in and made an impact straight away. Good innovative field setting. And good catching. Class work with the ball by Akil Hussain, fit again and making an impact. 105 for 9. Six required from the last five, one wicket left. Hello, Darren Ganga. How much this supporters be feeling?
Well, the supporters in red, they'll be happy with the situation. Last 30 balls, only 24 runs and five wickets to the Knight Riders. Narine. But the Warriors found themselves in a very good position. Sure, they'll reflect on a couple strokes and feel that it was speak.
Tim Paul still with his pads on. Shepherd bowled well tonight. Kishimoti, front and right, not playing in this game. Oh. His pads on still, so young players disappointed in not being able to make a contribution they wanted with the bat. Still 45 required, short leg and slip. Thank you. should be referred is
got to dive in. Tabriz Shamsi, he was searching for a single, then realized it was not on. Luckily, got back in time.
Oh! Overs for Russell Rampol to Pavilion. 106 for 9. Outstanding from Sunil Narine. 4 overs, 2 for 9. Spark Oval, where Sunil Narine plays his club cricket, his national or country ground. Outstanding.
Yeah, and all along we've been hearing about bowling straight lines. Sunil Narine, what impressed me the most about this spell is the line that he bowled, it was outside the off-stump, and he recognized that there was a bit of turn from the surface, so he wasn't too straight. He was always maybe fifth or sixth stump with his line, just challenging the batter to pick the deliveries which were turning in as against the ones that were going on. Really a champion bowler, Narine.
Desperate for 2 points, desperate. Both at the foot of a table, to Pavilion. Will fall short of seals. He's been good, to Pavilion. Got that wicket of Paul Sterling. And has bowled the fastest of the match, Andre Russell. Up under him in the FedEx fastest deliveries, Kimo Paul, Jaden Seals, Shepherd also on there. Very aggressive run, hits the crease hard, long limbs, levers.
I guess the moral of this story has to be, under pressure, you can't allow the opposition to get back into the game. At the halfway stage, you look at the target of 151 and you felt that the Warriors should cruise home to victory. Down the leg side, a wide. And when you look at the approach from the Warriors, just found they were ultra aggressive in that first six overs when it just required them to have intent, to recognize that the surface is allowing something for the bowlers. So you have to roll your sleeves up and work hard to grind runs out, grind a partnership out. That is something that they failed to do collectively. Six wickets falling in the middle phase of the innings.
Square leg umpire immediately says it's below waist height, so it won't be a no ball and a free hit.
And even in the first innings when Colin Munro and Tim Seifert were batting. I felt it was important for one of the two to bat all the way through and adopt that traditional approach to playing the T20 match. That's purely because of the conditions. We saw a couple deliveries keep low from bowlers bowling and operating from the pavilion end. So recognizing the conditions and playing accordingly, so crucial for T20 success. TKR surely adjusting better in this match, match number 18.
If you missed any of the action from this innings, here are the wickets. First, Paul Sterling to Dupavilon, and then Chandrapal Hemraj.
Henrik Claassen played like a millionaire and then he departed. Hetmyer didn't last long, trying to uppercut one without pace. Yeah! And Kimo Paul, first delivery, playing across the line. A little bit unlucky, the bounce on the low side. Colin Ingram gloved one to the wicketkeeper, and then this was horrible from Odine Smith. Shepherd, after his long stay at the crease, he was deceived by a faster yorker from Andre Russell, and the smarts of Hussein getting rid of Tahir. So Bish, as they say, how you make your bed, so shall you sleep on it. Just feel there was that lack of thought and appreciation for the conditions and the opposition bowlers in the batting approach from the Warriors.
Lessons to be learnt, and if TKR get across the line, they'll be happy. Nikita Miller on the left, former West Indies and Jamaican left-arm spinner, Abhishek Nair, the coach. And it'll be great credit to Pollard and his troops as well for being able to stay in it, even if they were looking for more than 150. But that's ahead of us. That's still another 40 required from. And it's gone for six. Junior Sinclair, 117 for nine.
First boundary for the young man, and it's a hero maximum. Opens up, gives it a full swing. Good resistance shown on debut.
Young man from Rosall Youth Club, Cricket Club. Pretensions as a batter, of course, an up-and-coming off-spinner and a dynamic fielder. Even if he had a little fumble in the field today. So 34 required from 18, and if it's one thing that the Patriots-Warriors match showed us is trying not to get too far ahead in terms of a result. Dre Russ.
Staying with Junior Sinclair, follows a decorated line of off-spinners out of Guyana. You think of Lance Gibbs, Roger Harper, Carl Hooper, Narsing Dayanarayan to a lesser extent. You would know by Tsunami Bish. Clyde Butts as well, I think, bowled a bit of off-spin. Former West Indian player from Guyana. Former chief selector for the West Indies.
To live up to for this Warriors team, hoping to get to the championship for the first time in franchise history. Work to do, though. 32 required. Nice shot. Guided away. Now only 28 required from 15.
Tabriz Shamsi always seems to have a fighting spirit within him, whether it's with ball or bat. The South African international always willing and ready for a contest. Here he is with the bat. Despite the desperate situation, he's still holding on with that belief that the Warriors can secure a further 28.
It was only the third boundary of his T20 career, 200 games. As the story goes for Junior Sinclair, it's a friend of his called Keith Simpson who introduced him to the game and to the club at the age of 11. Got him! What a wonderful victory! And Pollard says it's thanks to the higher-ups desperately needing these points. And this crowd deserves some celebration. Two valuable points for TKR. They win here by 26 runs and jump up the table into that fourth position. What a night.
Closing moment flawed. Junior Sinclair and the Warriors with that one delivery from Andre Russell. Expression of relief and thanks from the captain, Kyron Pollard. The Knight Riders, after being bowled out in their last game against the Royals, managed their highest individual score batting first and backed it up with a really professional showing with the ball. The Knight Riders winning by 26 runs tonight.
Outstanding work from Akil Hussain, 3 for 36. Andre Russell, third time he's taken three wickets in an innings in the CPL. Carib Girls keeping in rhythm. The TKR will know that there's work to do. The Warriors know that there's much work to do. Innovative field setting from Kyron Pollard attacking. With short legs, leg slip, slip fielders. Outstanding.
Yeah, they'll jump and celebrate because that was the initial expectation. Now that is fulfilled. And they will celebrate all the way into the night. The music, the carnival atmosphere will pave the way for the remaining two matches that the Knight Riders have at home, all the way south at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy.
.124 all out in 17.5 overs, 28 to Chanderpaul Hemraj being the top scorer, 20 to Shimron Epmeyer, 19 to Heinrich Klaassen. Junior Sinclair on table 14 at the back end.
The bowlers, with the exception of Rampal and Munro, were quite economical. Sunil Narine, simply sensational, with his 2-for-9 from 4-16 dots. And he was backed up by Akhil Hussain in his second match in Hero CPL 2022. 3 wickets for 36 runs. Both spinners really breaking the back of this Warriors batting lineup.
Always difficult trying to defend the total here at the Queen's Park Oval with the moisture in the outfield, but the Knight Riders getting to 150 for 8, courtesy Munro, 42, Seifert 27, Narine an important 26, Pollard 16 at the end, Shamsi brilliant, 4 wickets, Shepherd outstanding, 3. And then the Amazon Warriors capitulated. Russell with 3, Hussain on return with 3, and a couple for Narine for just 9. TKR by 26 runs. Let's go down to Tanvi.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the post-match presentation.